Welcome back to Quarantine Craft. I am Gas Man, and this is episode 12 of our Minecraft Let's Play. We've got a lot of fun stuff planned for today's episode. I got a couple of builds that I want to knock out. One is just purely fun, and the other is going to be fun and function. So I need to go build the respawn bunker at the end portal, and I need to build a creeper farm, because once we get this end dragon beat and I get my hands on some wings, I'm going to be a high flying gas man and it's going to be great. So I'm going to need lots and lots and lots and lots and like all the rockets. I'm going to need all the rockets, like every single rocket, all of them, all the rockets I'm going to need. So I need a gunpowder farm. I need a creeper farm. So I'm going to build a creeper farm and I'm going to build our respawn bunker, and I'm going to stock it up with all the little goodies and knickknacks that we're going to need to defeat the Ender Dragon. And we're going to have some fun, and I still absolutely love the way this area is lit at nighttime. It is so fun. So I am going to go have a sleep. I'm just here for the sleeps. Going to go have a sleep. And I am gonna grab some materials that I'm gonna need to build this respawn bunker. And then we're gonna take care of that, and it's gonna be great. So I will catch you guys once I've done that. Okay, so we are back in the stronghold once again. Gonna make this very easy to figure out where we're supposed to go once I get all the other guys here, and we'll boom. Up in, and we can just jump right on into that portal. So, I have a lot to do build-wise here. I'm going to make this look kind of like a barrack, but we're each going to have kind of our own little designated spots. So, like, that little section will be one of us. We'll do another one, say right here. Sorry, like here is a good spot. So each of us is going to have a little corner to kind of set up as our own, with bed, chest, stuff like that. Have this whole thing really well lit up, and that'll go away. Won't be needing that. So, that's going to be kind of the plan. I'm going to work on that, and then I will be back with you guys here in just a little bit. Neato. Yeah, so that didn't take me as long as I thought it was going to. Yeah. Just a nice little spot for the four of us to come tackle the dragon. Yeah. Cool. Alright, now to go start on that creeper farm. Well, I have found a spot to put in our creeper farm. I've got a little bit of leveling and a little bit of clearing out to do. I'm not going to go crazy with this. I know that it would be super effective if I were to go all the way down to bedrock and build it. I'm not going to do that. I don't feel like digging the hole that deep right now. So I'm just going to clear off the top up here and build it. And it will be good enough. It will not be the best it can be, but it will be good enough. So yeah, let me go ahead and get started on clearing that, and then we'll start on the farm itself. put in the footprint of the farm. That's how big it's going to be. Now, it is just time to get started on the farm. So, let's do that. Well, I've got most of the first level of the base dug out, but I want you guys to look around for a second. I'm going to let you in on one of my little secrets. One of the things that I think is really important when you build something is, just in the case that somebody might come along and see it, and for me, while I'm building it, I really like to keep everything consistent. If I've got a pallet, if I've got blocks I'm using for something, I want to keep using them. So, as I'm going around, when I'm seeing dirt peek through, I'm going to replace it with stone, or with these, with the smooth stone. So even like here, with this is going to be kind of a floor level for a few blocks out, I'm going to replace all of this dirt with stone, just so that it looks a little bit better. Yeah, no other reason. I just want it to look better, and I need to go make more stone. So I'm going to go make some more stone. Go smelt up some more smooth stone so that I can get in here and take care of all this. But I'm also not a big fan of wasting blocks. So as I'm coming through, I know those blocks are not going to be seen, so I'm fine leaving them as dirt. And if I know that, say, this block is going to get covered, boop, I'll make it dirt again. Not a problem. So I'm going to go smelt up some more smooth stone, and then I'm going to finish out this level of the base. And I want you guys to take a quick look at it right now and see what it looks like. Now, doesn't that look a whole lot better than with all the grass in there? It's nice. It's smooth. It makes sense. There's definitely something going on here. Next thing I'm going to do is put the water in, and I'm going to go grab a couple buckets, make an infinite water source, and then put in the water. And then I'm going to have to dig out a little bit more, so some of the stone's going to go, but it'll all make sense here in a minute. So I'm going to finish up the base, and then we'll start working on the tower itself. The base is now done. Now I've just got to build up the tower that goes up. I've also done the beginning of the collection system. It is not crazy. It is not special at all. It very much is just like we did with the slime farm on a much smaller scale. So, we're not going to be spending time down under here at all. I'm going to bring all of the drops out this way and build a little structure just kind of right here that just collects all the gunpowder and other possible drops we might get, like string and spider eyes, because sometimes this will decide it wants to be a spider spawner as well. I don't want these leaves here. Bye-bye, leaves. I will use you in something decorative later. The next step I need to do is build my redstone clock. Now, how this is going to work, I'm going to do an Etho Hopper clock. I just feel like I have more control with one of those than I do with most other ways of doing redstone. I understand them, I know how they work, and it just makes life easier for me. So I'm going to tuck it right here. This block right here is the center of, should be the center of my farm. And I'm going to place observers and dispensers, etc., etc., going up from here. So that's kind of the plan. And then I'll build out the layers, the spawning layers, as we go. So I'm going to put the clock in. If you've never done an Etho Hopper clock, they are not hard, but one thing they definitely require, as the name suggests, is hoppers. So make sure you have everything you need before you start building something. Hoppers. It makes life easier. It's kind of funny how that works. Bust out these little bits of dirt. Put them back in so I can come up here. Okay. So here we go. So that's gonna go there. Gonna put a dispenser there. Okay. Now, I need a sticky piston. And a sticky piston. I need a hopper going into another hopper. So these two hoppers need to be facing into each other. Then you have a comparator. I need a couple of actual blocks. So block slab here, and we go slab. Here, what I have is super ugly. Let me fix that real quick. And we'll replace that. Okay. Now, what am I forgetting? The redstone dust. I believe it's that. And there. And we're going to do that. And you'll see as the items move out of this hopper, because of the block, this hopper is locked, but it should not take very long for there we go, and it's just going to go back and forth, and every time it does, it's going to power that dispenser. So there is your standard Etho hopper. So I've got my first two platforms in, and as you can see, I'm still underneath the second one, because in order for this to be a creeper farm and not just a mob farm, you need to put in some trapdoors. So I'm going to throw in a bunch of trapdoors. And no, I'm not worried about a half block space in between them. Nobody's gonna see my floating trap door. My floating trap doors. This whole thing is going to be encased and not visible by the time it is totally finished. And the reason you do this is so that it's just creepers and spiders that can spawn. Nothing else is spawnable, and I missed a block right there. Okay, so I'm going to fill this in with trapdoors, and goodbye, creeper. Goodbye. I hope you've had fun. Now, die. Nice. Bye-bye, creeper. Oh, there's another one. There goes another one. Nice. I I've powered through, managed to put all of the spawning levels, all of the trap doors, and the roof on this. I've still got a little ways to go. I'm going to encase this so that it is completely 100% pitch black dark in there. So I'm a little close right now for everything to be spawning appropriately. But as you saw as I was coming over to this spot, there were some creepers falling and dying, which is good. This is working. Hey, what's up, spider? How you doing? How's that spider doing? You gonna jump off? You just gonna jump off? Oh, you're not just gonna jump off. Sad. Sad. Oh well. So I think that is gonna do it for us today. If you enjoyed today's video, be sure to hit the like button. And if you haven't already, be sure to go ahead and subscribe, because I know what's coming next. I think we're going to get together and we're going to kill a dragon. That dragon's going to die, and I'm going to get me some wings. I'm going to get some wings. So I can start flying around this server. Yes. Super excited about that. We're going to have a great time. It's going to be fun. So I think what we're planning next is dragon fight and some inbusting. So make sure you subscribe so that you don't miss any of the fun. And I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.